Our question this week comes from Diane Roche about small branches on the ground in her Leander neighborhood, including around her honey locust. Diane reports that these branches haven't simply broken due to the wind. They look as if they've been cut. She tells us that when this happens, trees drop many branches all at once, which is very alarming. Well, Diane, although it's definitely alarming to see lots of broken pieces on the ground around our precious trees, I'm happy to assure you that this problem isn't something that the trees can't handle and recover from. The culprit here is a little insect known as a twig girdler, which does exactly what its name suggests. It cuts a circular section around the tips of the smallest branches in trees, which makes those tips vulnerable to breaking off and falling to the ground. So you'll definitely notice an infestation after a windstorm, when the ground around trees may be completely covered with broken twigs. Adult twig girdlers feed on the tender bark, then the females lay eggs on the tips of the branches they've just girdled. This is by design and is a very specific part of the life cycle of this insect. The deposited eggs will hatch into larvae, which will feed on the dead tree tissue once it breaks off and falls to the ground. So the best way to break this cycle is to rake up and toss all of those twigs around the trees in the whole neighborhood and discard them. As I said, this isn't usually too much of a problem for most trees, but it can negatively affect nut production in pecan trees, and repeat or heavy infestations can cause deformities in growth. Diane's fabulous question gives me an opportunity to nerd out on terminology and to point out where I've often had challenges assisting people in my career as an extension agent. The more deeply versed we are in our particular field, the less tuned our ears become to broader terms, which people seeking our help might use, not being as nerdy about terminology as we are. When I first read Diane's question and saw the word branch, I pictured a medium-sized tree limb, and twig girdlers didn't immediately jump to mind. Once she added the information about the branches seeming to have been cut, it helped me to the correct conclusion. To plant people, branch is a pretty general term, usually describing a stick of any size, and a twig is a very, very small stick. When we say the two words together, branch and twig, I think most people would have a clear distinction in their mind between the two terms. Our plant of the week is Don Juan Climbing Rose, an easy care climber that quickly grows to 8 to 10 feet tall and about half as wide. You'll definitely want to provide a trellis, arbor, or other support for Don Juan, which will be covered with deep red blooms each spring and early summer. What the blooms lack in fragrance, they more than make up for in color and abundance. Hardy to zone 6, Don Juan will drop its leaves each winter and should be maintenance pruned after flowering. Add organic matter, such as good quality compost, to the planting bed, and water Don Juan regularly during the hottest, driest of times. Plant in at least 6 hours of full sun and mulch the soil around the root zone. From our viewers, Cynthia Hernandez sent in a great shot of her starfish cactus, Staphylia grandiflora, also known as carrion plant, and Susan Velzi captured this happy little toad. We'd love to hear from you. Visit centraltexasgardener.org to send us your questions, pictures, and videos.